So, hello to everyone. Today we are going to go in the details regarding the last technology, which is the thermal oxidation. In the previous webinar, we have seen the active carbon technology, the washing tower technology, and today we're going to see the last one. So in this way, you can have a general overview regarding all the technologies for VOC treatment in half filtration. And let's start again briefly to summarize again which are the VOC, what is a VOC, and how can we treat them. So basically, VOCs are organic compounds, molecules that are in the gas phase. So in each filtration, we have several solutions for dust, oil, and VOC. And VOC are molecules in a gaseous phase. You see here halides, alcohols, hydrocarbons, and so on. Everything in gas phase. You can have acid compounds, basic compounds, alcohols, and so on. Which are the fields where we can find this kind of VOC? Basically, everywhere. Because we can find it in chemical, pharmaceutical, surface treatment, but also die casting, automotive, thermal treatment. And so on. This because in every place that we have a problem of odor or toxic compound, that is a VOC, and we need to treat them. Companies need to treat them in order to guarantee the safety of the and the environmental sustainability of the process and so on. So very broad application. Please keep in mind that also all the section of the odors of the bad smell are included in this in the VOC treatment field because bad smells are VOC. And as I was saying before, we have seen active carbon technology in the previous webinar, which is a technology where you have the adsorption of the gaseous compound to the surface of the carbon. Then we have seen the washing tower technology in another webinar, which is a technology where your gaseous compound, your VOC, goes inside, is solubilized in the water of the washing tower. Okay. Today we're going to see the oxidation. Oxidation is a technique that involves the complete conversion, the destruction of the VOC. You see, you have your VOC, your pollutant, and you have with oxygen and temperature, you have a reaction, the oxidation, the combustion, and you have the formation of water and carbon dioxide. So in the case of active carbon and washing tower, we have to dispose the wastewater and active carbon spent after a certain period, and we need to dispose them. In this case, we have the destruction theoretically of the VOC. This is the fundamental difference. Of course, you need temperature and you need oxygen. So this is crucial because otherwise you cannot, you need all the elements. Of course, this system, sometimes for the working of this system, you need, in addition to the pollutant, also a fuel in order to sustain the combustion environment, let me say. So, as I told you, we have a combustion, and the combustion happens in a chamber, okay? And usually this is a configuration of the RTO. RTO is a regenerative thermal oxidizer. Thermal oxidizer, I explained you why, but regenerative because we have some packing material, ceramic packing material that we will see in details later. And what happens? We have here the polluted air, okay? We go inside this bed, but this stream is cold. Okay, I don't know, 50 degrees, 30 degrees, 70 degrees, cold stream with the pollutant. You go inside the chamber, you have the oxidation, and of course, you have the oxidation, you have the increasing of the temperature. So after you have the stream hot with a higher amount of energy, of thermal energy. So basically, if you have just the burner, you are wasting a lot of energy because here you have a hot stream and you are not doing anything with that hot stream. So in this optimized technology for thermal oxidation, you have that after the combustion, you have this pollutant and this stream that goes through a ceramic bed and leave the heat to the ceramic bed. The ceramic bed capture the heat, the thermal energy, and after the first cycle, you have the switching of the valve, and you have that your cold stream goes inside the bed that was heated before. And in this way, you have a preheating of the stream. And so, why this is important? Because here you don't have any more a stream cold, but a stream that has already a high temperature, 400 degrees, 500 degrees, and so on. And this is good because I can decrease the fuel for the combustion chamber till a threshold where the system is completely auto-sustained. Okay, because I have cold stream here, combustion, here heat stream that leave thermal energy to the bed, to the ceramic bed. And then we have the switching of the valve and we have the preheating of the stream. And this is a continuous process. This is the term regenerative. Thermal oxidizer. Regenerative means that you have the regeneration of the bed, of the ceramic bed, and you have an increased thermal efficiency of the system. Very high thermal efficiency, close to 95-99%. If you have questions, you can type on the chat, and we can go deeply, but we are here to also support you in every time, but this is the concept. This is a two bed configuration and this is a three bed configuration. The concept is exactly the same. What happened is that sometimes here in the two bed configuration you can have during the switching of the bed some VOC that remain captured in the ceramic bed. It's just a further optimization. With the three bed configuration and the proper switching of the valve, we avoid also these things. But the concept is exactly the same. We are using the thermal energy of the combustion chamber to preheat the feed. You in the three chamber configuration, you have some air in order to clean also the bed, switching the valve in a certain time. And let's see. Here, another example you see with the three bed configuration. So you have the polluted air here, then you have the ceramic elements inside the bed, Then you have the combustion chamber in the upper part, and then you have the clean air outlet. Of course, this kind of system, lots of engineering needs to be done in order to do the proper insulation of the combustion chamber, the proper insulation of the honeycomb, the packing material, and so on. And some engineering details very important, but very known in our technology. This is an example of an RTO installed, and you see this is a three chamber RTO. And then we were talking before about this kind of ceramic bed. Just to give you an idea, here is an ordered ceramic bed, but you can have also a random ceramic bed like this one. See, you have this is a saddle shape ceramic. You can have also in different material, because depending of which kind of VOC do you have, because maybe in some cases there are fluorinated VOC, so you need to proper choose the packing material, the ceramic material. So there are several types, but this is the concept. Okay, here something that I already told you about the system to reverse the beds, ventilator, stack, and so on. The ceramic bed is fundamental for the working of this kind of technology. Okay, so now let's go to see a remote control, because of course this kind of technology has a compare. We can see, I can show you another graph that we can monitor in order to see what I was saying. Here, for example, in this graphic, we can monitor the temperature in the combustion chamber and all the other temperature, and also the pressure and so on. So the system, you see here the set point, the PLC completely manage everything. And we can add other things if the customer want a VOC sensor, we can put it, or other temperature sensor or other control system, we can do it. So flexibility and technology are fundamental to go together, and all our plans are studied and applied in this way. Okay, so I think we can go again in the on the screen. Yeah, so we have seen the we can study also the layout, of course, all the piping, because you can imagine, like in the case of dust, like in the case of oil, the suction system is fundamental. Okay, so the suction system is fundamental. And also in the case of VOC, if you properly manage the captation, so you can change also the concentration of the pollutant in the air, and so you can influence directly also the efficiency of the RTO. Because the higher is the value of the VOC, the lower is the consumption of methane that I need to use in order to sustain the combustion inside the chamber. This is an example of two bed configuration, and we have time for questions, but the point is the general overview regarding the working principle and all the important things in this technology were addressed. So tell me, Martina, we have some questions?
Okay, for the moment we don't have any questions, but maybe we can go through some of the most frequently asked questions.
Okay.
Okay, so what is the difference in cost compared to other various technologies?
Okay, this is an important point because of sure this technology will have usually an higher capital investment compared to active carbon, for example, or washing tower. But this needs to always be compared with also the running cost. And this is what we usually do. We do an estimation of the capital investment, but also the running cost. Because if I have a very high amount of VOC at the inlet, probably the lifetime of the carbon will be very low. Of course, it is always a matter of calculation, and we support every partner and customer in this way. But the cost is always, the answer is always depends case by case. And we need to properly understand also the type of VOC, because there are some VOC that can be treated with a washing tower, and so the RTO is not necessary. I don't know, you have a VOC that is, I don't know, formaldehyde, or formaldehyde is a good case, or methanol, you have methanol, and you can oxidize methanol or treat methanol with the solubilization in a washing tower, in a scrubber. Of course, if the concentration is medium low, so I mean, I don't know, 500 milligram per cubic meter, and the flow rate is 10,000 cubic meter per hour. So maybe in that case, both technologies, the oxidizer and the washing tower, can be applied. But of course, washing tower have a less investment cost. But with the washing tower, you have to dispose the water, and so we need also to consider other things. But it always a matter of comparison.
Okay. So another frequently asked question is how much is the fuel consumption?
Yeah, the fuel consumption is strongly dependent of which the amount of VOC that we have, because here we have the pollutant that sustain the flame with the oxygen. But if I have a low concentration of the pollutant, I need the methane or other fuel in order to sustain the flame. And so if the fuel consumption always depend with the concentration of the pollutant. If you have, I don't know, 2 grams of VOC with a good thermal energy, you can avoid the use of fuel when you are in the stationary conditions. Otherwise, you need some fuel. So it always depends.
Okay. So is the energy recovery possible with an RTO system?
Yes. Also, this depends case by case, because it depends the amount of the flow rate that you have and how we can proper size the RTO. But yes, after here, after the beds, you can put a heat exchanger system in order to recover some heat and use this heat for water that then can be used in other part of the plant or for other purposes.
Okay, so let's suppose that we are in presence of dust. How much does the uptake affect the efficiency of an RTO, and is the presence of dust a problem for the system?
Yes, this is an important point. If we have a very high amount of dust, I don't know, gram per cubic meter, or also critical type of dust, of course we need to put a pretreatment system with a filtration before the RTO. And this is always the concept that we promote and we want to use in every application, as H filtration, because several times we have problem of dust and VOC, or oil and VOC, or dust and oil, and we need to combine several technologies. And if you don't manage properly the technology, the risk is that you don't obtain your result. You don't solve the problem. And in this way, combining different technologies can solve the problem, and dust is one of the critical things for the RTO that in certain amount needs to be eliminated.
Okay, so as you have already mentioned, when offering a VOC abatement systems, we always study the best solution on a case by case basis. But let's suppose that the specifications change afterwards. So I mean, is it possible to change the parameters remotely if, for instance, I change the production cycle from 8 hours to, let's say, 12 hours?
Of course, yes. It always depends about the amount of VOC and so on. But yes, for example, tomorrow in the we will have a changing of the parameter of the customer, the software changing, because he changed the he optimized the sanction system, and so now he has another kind of VOC concentration, and with a software programming will adapt the valve switching and all the program basing on the request of the customer. Of course, you have a flexibility, but depends case by case, cannot be 100% of flexibility. But especially during the design conditions, if we know that the customer wants flexibility, and we know which more or less will be the variation of the flow rate or the VOC or other things, yes, we can properly customize the technology to the request, also estimated of the customer.
Okay, so we have one last question, which is about maintenance. Does ordinary maintenance have to be carried out by specialized technicians, or can it be carried out by internal maintenance technicians?
Depends in which kind of part of the RTO you need to change and to maintenance. Usually. This system, you can leave this system and you don't need maintenance. Operation in 2 years, 3 years. It always depends on the application, also this. I repeat this sentence because it is fundamental to consider that these are not standard application, but we need case by case to solve properly the problem. And if you need to clean the bed, is the ceramic bed, in some application also if the customer has a proper training, can do by himself, otherwise we support with our people and technicians the maintenance, and other things are the valve. Yeah, you see all the switching valve that I was explaining before. Also, in that case, you need some maintenance, just cleaning and so on. But not in the short time. In the short time, I mean, if the RTO is properly designed, you can live there without doing anything. It's not like other applications. It's not like, for example, the active carbon that you need to change. Of course, depends on the amount of VOC and the lifetime of the carbon, but it is not so intensive like in that case. Of course, you have other drawbacks, for instance, the capital investment, which is pretty different. Okay.
Okay, so at the moment we don't have any more questions, but we are always here to answer the questions we people might have. So I guess for now that's all.
Thanks, Martina. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Matteo. Thank
you, everyone. And yes, for every further questions, we are here. And thanks for participating to these webinars in the following weeks. And we will be other promoting and initiative in HP creation. So stay connected with us. And thank you again. Proud to be a chair. Bye bye to everyone.